I thank you that you always hear me. Father, I thank you that today, let this word change the heart of man. Let it knock out every sickness, every disease, every demon. And let your word prevail in our lives, oh God. For the Bible says, mightily grew the word of God, and it prevailed. Let your word prevail over us today. In every circumstance, in the name of Jesus. We honor you, Lord. We give you praise in Jesus' name. I read verse 12 again. And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him and said unto him, the Lord is with thee, thou mighty man of valor. Angel appeared to Gideon. And the angel introduced him and said, you are a mighty man of valor. Verse 13, and Gideon said unto him, oh my Lord, if the Lord be with us, why then is all this befalling us? And where be all his miracles which our father told us of the saying, did not the Lord bring us up from Egypt? But now the Lord has forsaken us and delivered us unto the hands of the Midianites. He saw himself as nobody, nonentity, inconsequential. He was irrelevant in the society. That is the way he saw himself. But the angel came and told him, no, you are a mighty man of valor. A mighty man of valor means a man who is a conqueror, a fighter, a warrior. But this man has never fought any war. He's a courageous warrior. He's called mighty man of valor. But this man knew he had never fought any war. And the man went on to say, listen to what he said. He went on to describe himself. He said, listen, angel, you got it wrong. I am from a poor family. Even in my own village, our own is the poorest among the poorest. When a poor person, you are passing, and the poor people stay at the door and say, oh my God, look at poor person. You know, you can understand that. Poor people now started laughing at other poor people. You can think about that. That is a description of acute poverty. And it was such to his own mind. But God saw him differently. How are you seeing yourself? How are you seeing yourself? But today, I'm only going to open two people that introduced the same man. The first one I said was God. God introduced him. What did God call him? Mighty man of valor. But I want to show you something. What an enemy called him. Go to the same book of Judges chapter 8. Judges chapter 8. Hallelujah. Go to Judges chapter 8. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And I want to summarize let me get to the verse. Judges chapter 8 to verse 18. Go to verse 18. Are we there?
Yes, sir.
Who can read verse 18 for me?
Then said he unto Zebab and to Zalmunna, what manner of men were they whom ye slew at Tabor? And they answered, as thou art, so were they.
Okay, why I wanted somebody else to read it so that you will know, it's the same thing in my Bible. Daughter, God bless you. So that you know, it's the same thing in my Bible. Let me read it from here. Then said he unto Zeba and Zumana, that is two men that came, what manner of men were they who you slay at Tabor? What kind of people are these people that you kill? Gideon was asking the two men that he saw that reported to him, we have just killed two people. Listen to what he said. And he said, the two men said to him, and they answered, as thou art, so they were. They are just like you. If they had stopped there, he said not to cause pain. So you kill somebody that is just like me? Is somebody hearing me?
Yes.
Even if you were poor or so, that is enough to have caused you an injury. They said, who is it that you kill? Who are the cats? He said, the people we kill, they are just like you. And they went further to explain to him. They said, each one resembled the children of a king. Meaning, they were telling him, the people we killed, they were a resemblance of the sons of a king. But they were talking to Gideon, who said he was nobody. He never knew he looked like the son of a king. But an enemy was able to know who he was. Do you know your enemy knows about you?
Yes, sir.
They know details about you. This is why they are attacking you. But you don't see yourself, but they know your potential. They know this could be the president, the next president. This could be the director of a company. This could be the one to save the family. What they do, they steal your star. They tamper with your destiny. They tamper with your glory. Because even from the day one you are born, those with a spiritual eye can read your destiny. This enemy came. They challenged, they said, who is it that you killed? He said, the people, they are just like you. And then they went further. I said, they have the resemblance like the sons of kings. When I read this place, I said, oh Gideon, God came down and called you mighty man of valor. You didn't know who you were. Now the enemies have come to say you look like the son of a king. And yet you don't know. And many people are like that. Why you are suffering? Because you don't know who you are. Mine. Assignment today is to unveil to you that you are a royalty.
Amen.
That you are a son of a king.
Amen.
In Revelation chapter 5 verse 10, he says he has made you to be a king. That is who you are.
Amen.
In honor to God Almighty. He made you. You are a king. Don't look down on yourself. A king does not speak anyhow. How does a king speak? His words are powerful. When a king speaks, the words are authority. They are laws. You are a king. This is why most of you are saying you are not serious. Because your words, you have joked too much. When you say devil go, you know you are joking. Yeah, you getting me? You don't waste your words. When I said in the name of Jesus, you are back on the floor. Most of you have seen it. The person will turn around, fall on the floor. Why? Because my words are not mine. They are words of God that lives on the inside of me. As I'm speaking to you now, I just believe in me. This is my own. That there is no devil that is able to stand against you.
Amen.
Because the words I'm speaking today is that I'm taking you from where you were to make you who God has made you to be. You are a warrior.
Amen.
Courageous warrior.
Amen.
You are a royalty.
Oh, yes.
You are a king.
Amen.
You are a king. Today when you stand, don't be afraid. You point hand on the devil. Don't speak about the devil. Ah, you know my problem. Ah, it's too much. You are speaking about the mountain. No, don't speak. Speak to the mountain.
Amen.
Don't speak about it. You know my problem. They just say I should go. They just say they didn't pray this. They said the pain is here and it's also in my leg. The pain is also in my head. This one, you are talking about the mountain. You point to the hand. You say, devil, you can't have my body. For my body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. I command you out of my body. You speak with authority. That devil, we go.
Amen.
Because he knows you are serious.
Yes.
Is somebody hearing?
Yes, sir.
That is who you are. But because you don't know, you are suffering. He said, for they know none, and they shall all die like the children of men. But I say, you are God.
Amen.
Why are you not taking that? Listen, this one is not to boast. I work with Dunlop Nigerian PSC. From there, I resigned to come to Germany as a student. That day, I was employed into a factory. I have to enter into a factory. I worked there for 8 days in the factory. My uncle is late now. He said, you are looking for work. Come and start from factory. Often they look for people in the office. I went into the factory. And it was not very pleasant. But in Nigeria, I worked in the factory for 8 days. And then there was this advert, internal advert. They are looking for sales rep. People that would be in sales. So you can imagine Nigeria. Even external people, all of them, they came down. People were in the same with qualifications. All of them wrote, and we all came out. On the day of interview, each one will be entering the room. There were about 4 or 5 men, I've forgotten the picture now, of the same people who will interview you. And all of them, they wear boba and sokoto. Some of them. Are you understand what is called boba? Native dress.
Yeah.
So many of them. But me, that day, I put on suit with tie. I suit up. I don't have anybody. in that place. They were all Yorubas. I'm sorry to use that word. Yeah. I don't even speak Yoruba. But they want somebody that will go to Ibadan to represent them. So the people speaking Yoruba with qualification are more qualified. But they were interviewing. When it was my turn, I went in there. They all looked at themselves. They said, listen to what he said. Do we need to interview him? He has already dressed up for the job. I'm telling you.
Amen.
He has already dressed up for the job. We talk of sales. This is the quality of sales. Yeah. That was how I was taken. That same day, transfer. They put me under training and took me to Ibadan under sales reps to represent Dunlop Tire PSC. That was how. Just ordinary dress. They didn't interview me. They said my dress had given me the job. When I came out, everybody was saying, ah, Baba Jimo is my uncle, you know, the managing director, the personal manager. All of them, they were speaking it. Me, I don't have uncle, I don't have anything, but my dress was my uncle.
Amen.
Is somebody hearing me? As I came out, out of more than 200, only two of us were taken. I was number one. What happened? I dressed up for the job. What am I trying to say? Dress up for the job from today.
Amen.
Amen.
Dress up for the job from today.
Amen.
When you wake up in the morning, you say, this day belongs to me.
Yes.
I'm in charge. Goodness and mercy are following me.
Amen.
Dress up for the day.
Amen.
Are somebody hearing me? Dress up for the day. Don't be afraid. You are more than a conqueror.
Mm.
You are not like Gideon. See yourself as a victor.
Amen.
Dress up for the day.
Oh, yes.
Possess the day. Whatever you say, as man, think it in his heart, so is he.
Amen.
What you think, that is who you are.
Yes.
Don't think defeat. Think yourself. Don't look down yourself. No, just feel that you are a son of God.
Amen.
A child of God.
Mm.
He listens you. He loves you. Mm. Everyone could hate you, but he loves you.
Amen.
Amen.
Is somebody hearing me? Clap your hands for that. Come on. From today, don't look inferior to yourself. Look at this man. It was an enemy that told him who he was.
Mm.
He said, we just keep two men. He said, how are they? He said, like you, like the son of the king. Before the man knew, oh, you have just, if you follow him, he said, you've just killed.
Mm.
But for my brother,
mm.
before he knew.
Mm-hmm.
But they told him the secret. I'm here to tell you, you are like the son of the king.
Amen. Amen.
You are the son of a king, not even like, is somebody hearing me?
Amen.
So today, dress up for the job. Look up. Nobody can deport a member of Living Water.
Amen.
Amen.
It has not happened and it cannot happen.
Amen.
They are deported people. I stand here to prophesy. It's my covenant with my maker.
Amen.
None of you will be deported.
Amen. Amen.
I spread the umbrella of protection over you.
Amen.
I said I spread the umbrella of protection over you.
Amen.
Remember what I told you. There may be shaking. You might see the rain. It could touch your leg, but it will never touch your head.
Amen.
Because there is a covering over your life.
Amen.
There is a covering.
Amen.
And I spread the umbrella and the spirit over you in the name
Amen.
Of Jesus.
Amen.
No deportation. They can't deport you. If they put you, if it's in the plane, the plane will not start.
Yeah.
It will start.
Yeah.
Because Allah summer, I stand on the altar to pronounce it so.
Yeah.
I stand on the altar to pronounce it. God will fight your battle.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus.